Welcome back to Danganronpa. Last time, we finished our investigation. I had to off-screen like 20 minutes because I couldn't figure out where to go. And now it's time for the class trial. Let's get this started.
You!
Listen to me!
But who is the killer?
Is everyone here? Okay then, please board the elevator in front of you, which will transport you to the courtroom, where all your fates will be decided. I'll meet you all down there. I'll be waiting.
All right. Well, let's go in.
Well then.
Yes, indeed. Hey, Makoto.
I like that. It's like, I could help solve this crime, but you've got to figure it out, man. If that's actually how that's gonna go, then fuck her. She's stupid. Dumb teenagers.
Oh.
Well, here we go. Ah, kinda.
Shit.
Well now. Yoo-hoo!
Wow. Oh god, they have little signs for each person that's already dead. Well, that does it for the prep. That would have been a better way to end last episode, but whatever, I can't tell pacing. I don't know the format, guys. Ooh, what? Set skills. Cool and composed. Steadies your aim a little. Effective during the non-stop debate and the hang... What?! Fine. Robot Jock. Increases your truth bullet rate of fire. Effective during the non-stop debate and bullet time battle finals. Okay, what is going on? Increases your damage to the opponent when a statement is destroyed. That's all the skills I have. Fine. Go. Arise!
Let's begin with a basic explanation of the class trial. So, your votes will determine the results. If you can figure out who done it, then only they will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong one, then I'll punish everyone besides the blackened, and the one that deceived everyone else will graduate.
Hooray!
And the killer really is one of us, right?
Okay then. Everyone, close your eyes. And whoever did it, raise your hand.
Don't be a goddamn idiot. Why the hell would they raise their hand?
Oh, is this actually all voice? Because this is actually really good.
Before we move on and start the trial, can I ask a question real quick? What's going on with those pictures?
I'd feel awful if they got left out just because they died. Friendship penetrates even death's barrier. Friendship penetrates?
I'm sweating bathtubs.
Okay, but what about that other empty seat? There were only 15 of us to begin with, so why are there 16 seats?
Oh, she has an accent.
Oh, no reason. It's just that our little courtroom here can technically fit up to 16 people.
I call bullshit on that.
Okay, that about does it for the preamble. Get ready to get started. First up is the case summary. Now, let the class trial begin.
It's about to begin, the debate to decide who we think the killer is. Anything I found, anything I noticed, I have to be ready to speak up about everything. Because this isn't just about me. Everyone's lives are on the line. Your first non-stop debate is about to begin. Would you like to hear more? Yeah. As things progress during each class trial, you'll engage in a number of non-stop debates. During these discussions, characters will speak one after another without pause. It's up to you to unearth any lies or contradictions buried within their statements. What this means is you'll have to use your truth bullets to refute what they say. Any relevant truth bullets you found during your investigation will be loaded into the truth cylinder. Use the left stick to aim and then fire. Are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? Pay close attention to their statements and use the bullets. Note that if you run out of time, you'll automatically fail. If you press start during these arguments, you can review the controls. Good luck, have fun. Make your argument. Evidence of a struggle.
I assert that the one who was murdered was Miss Sayaka Maizono.
Yeah, we know that part already.
And the murder took place in Makoto's room.
In the bathroom. So it seems most likely that the killer must have taken her by surprise while she was in the bathroom. She didn't even have a chance to hide. She didn't even have a chance to repeat.
No, it's wrong.
Got it. So, you have to hit the words with the words. My bad. It didn't count me hitting her with it.
Try to remember how my room looked.
Yeah, so, my bad. I may have wasted 2 minutes of this debate because I didn't know where you're supposed to shoot the bullet.
With the way things had been damaged, I think we can definitely assume there was a struggle.
A struggle? Between who and who?
Between Sayaka and the killer, of course.
So you're saying Sayaka wasn't caught by surprise in the bathroom?
She must have been attacked in the main room first. Then, she ran to the bathroom to try and hide. The killer followed her in, and that's where they finished the job.
That much should have been obvious after taking one look at the scene. It shouldn't even need explaining.
Sorry.
Okay, so what's next?
Next is the subject of the murder weapon.
Wow, this is starting to sound like a real trial.
Alright, back to this again. Kitchen knife set. Yeah, that's our bullet. Let's do it then.
So what was used to kill her?
There was some kind of sharp object thrust into her stomach. Without a doubt, that is the murder weapon.
So the killer used some random knife they had on him.
No, it's wrong.
I'm getting it now.
No, I do think it was a knife, but not just any knife. I'm almost positive it was a kitchen knife.
Huh? A kitchen knife?
After the murder, we discovered that one of the knives from the kitchen was missing.
Which means that knife must be the murder weapon.
Oh, yeah. I guess that makes sense. You could sort of see the weapon sticking out of her stomach. And if you look real close, I could totally see that being a kitchen knife.
Okay, so the murder weapon was a kitchen knife, but where does that get us? I mean, we all know Makoto killed her, right?
That's right. Makoto's room was the scene of the crime. What more proof do you need?
Hold on a second. I'm...
Let's draw our conclusions after we've presented our arguments. Otherwise, what's the point of the trial?
Well, we can talk all we want. It's not going to change that conclusion.
Oh, you're so fucking guilty, dude.
I don't think that's true at all. I'm sure if we keep at it, something new will reveal itself.
You really believe that?
There's a bit more to learn about non-stop debates. Sure. You can concentrate by holding down the R1 button, I guess. While you're concentrating, time will slow down. Okay. Alright. Sure. Oh, here we go again. Oh yeah, we can use her account on saying that while she was getting tea, the bullets.
So I guess
yeah,
there's no question that the kitchen knife was the murder weapon. But where does that get us?
Koto must have taken it from the kitchen, Brett. He did it in secret. Nobody was in the dining hall.
No.
Didn't really need to concentrate for that one.
Okay, wait. Hold on. I didn't take the knife from the kitchen.
Next, you're gonna say you're not the killer, right? Go ahead and say it all you want.
Well, what if I have a witness? What do you think, Hina?
Huh?
Remember what you were telling me earlier? Just to be perfectly clear, the knife disappeared while you were in the dining hall, correct?
Yeah, that's right.
And at any point while you were there, did you ever see me come into the dining hall?
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so?
No, he definitely wasn't there.
The knife disappeared while Hina was in the dining hall, but I wasn't there the entire time. In other words, there's no way I could have taken the knife.
Yeah!
Okay, then what about this? What if the idiot swimmer girl and Makoto are in on it together, and lying to protect each other?
Idiot swimmer girl? Oh, and more importantly, why would I get involved in something like that?
Speaking of which, I'd like to ask the bear, if there is an accomplice, do they also become blackened?
So you ask, and so I shall answer. Each murder is allowed to have an accomplice, but only the one who does the killing will get to graduate.
So in other words, two people can work together, but one of them has no chance of profiting from it.
Then there's no way anyone would work together, right?
But what if they did work together, and they just didn't know about the rule?
Good grief! Enough already! No, okay? There are no accomplices in this case! Oops! Did I say that out loud?
Oops!
Anyway, I didn't go to the dining hall, and I didn't take the knife. So I'm not the killer!
Okay, so then, who did take the knife?
Hina seems the obvious candidate. After all, she just said she was in the dining hall.
Oh, no!
No way! I swear it wasn't me!
Sure, but can you or anyone else prove that?
I can.
That's
oh!
Right. Sakura was with me the entire time I was drinking my tea.
I hate to have to ask, but just to be sure, Sakura's...
me.
Right.
But then, couldn't either one of them have grabbed the knife?
Actually, no. Because, well...
Just spit it out already.
I stayed in Hina's room last night.
I got so scared thanks to those creepy videos. I wasn't really thinking, I just asked her to stay over.
Which means, we have airtight alibis.
You stayed over? Doesn't that violate one of the school regulations?
Nope.
We're not allowed to sleep anywhere but the dorms. But it doesn't say we have to stay in our assigned room. So, I don't think that's a problem.
It is a problem! A boy and a girl spending the night together? It's unwholesome!
Okay, Taka, I've got some news for you.
I'm a girl.
Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry.
But if it wasn't either of you, then what other possibility is there?
Actually, there is one other possibility. Right, Hina?
Oh, yeah, that's true. One other person did come to the dining hall while we were there.
Why didn't you say so in the first place?
Well, because they're not here anymore.
Junko.
Sayaka.
Oh, Sayaka.
She's the one who came to the dining hall. And then later, she wound up dead.
Oh, God, this is getting bad. Oh, no.
I got it! Then, Sayaka is the one who took the knife?
That's the only possibility. And thinking back on it, she was acting kind of unusual. When she came into the dining hall, she didn't even look at us. She just went straight to the kitchen. As she left, she said she just wanted a drink of water. But most likely...
Then the person who took the knife was the victim herself. I'm sure
she just took it for self-defense.
After that video, I doubt it.
So you're saying the knife she took was then taken from her, and she was killed with it? In that case, you may not have taken the knife, but you still could have killed her.
Oh, Christ.
See? He did do it after all.
You have a boner for getting me killed.
No, you're wrong.
So, that's how you would twist the argument and send us all off in the wrong direction? You possess a most terrifying talent.
Well, this is bad.
Hold on. It's still too early to decide conclusively that Makoto is the killer, wouldn't you say? Because you see, if the room did belong to the killer, then they did something most bewildering. And until we unravel that little mystery, you simply can't declare that he's the killer.
Switching the name plates?
Bewildering? What the hell are you talking about?
Something was missing from the scene of the crime that by all rights should have been there.
Hair?
You know what I'm talking about, don't you?
Your first hangman's gambit? What the fuck is that? As things advance further, the hangman's gambit will eventually take place. The point of this is to reveal the important phrase related to the incident. You'll have to deduce the phrase from the letters flying around and the letters already known. Complete the phrase by shooting down flying letters in the right order. Left stick to aim, X to hit. You can also tap. Shoot down the wrong letters, you'll suffer damage to your influence gauge. Reaches zero, run out of time, you fail. Okay. Something that should have been at the scene but wasn't. Alright, I'm thinking about it. Hair. Hair is the only thing I can think of. But it also wouldn't make sense if I killed her in the bathroom because I broke the lock on the door. I know about the door. Hangman's gambit. Four letters, it's hair. Oh, okay, it didn't count as me hitting it yet.
Now we got it.
Look at that cool break effect.
That's right. There wasn't a single hair on the floor.
So, the culprit removed some evidence?
Yes. And if I were the culprit, why would I need to get rid of all the hair in my own room? It wouldn't be unusual at all to find my hair at the crime scene if the crime scene is in my room.
The reason all the hair was gone was to remove any trace that Sayaka had ever been there. That makes sense, does it not?
No. If that were the case, they would have had to do something about the body itself, not just her hair.
Ha ha ha! Yes, very true, very true!
Okay, then why wasn't there any hair on the ground?
The killer got rid of it all, of course, to remove any trace that they had ever been there.
Wait, then that means...
Precisely. It's simply beyond reason to believe that the room's owner and the killer are one and the same.
Then, Makoto isn't the culprit?
Are you sure we can decide something so important based solely on the absence of some hair?
No. There are other reasons that prove why Makoto couldn't have done it.
I would like to hear these reasons.
Do you remember anything remarkable about the bathroom at the scene? Sayaka was attacked in the main room first, then fled into the bathroom, right?
Yeah, then they ran after her, got into the bathroom, and stabbed her.
And how did the killer get into the bathroom? Did they have any trouble with it?
What do you mean?
It's fairly certain that the killer had some trouble getting into the bathroom. There was clear evidence left behind. Do you remember, Makoto?
Yes.
I got it!
Evidence that the killer had trouble getting into the bathroom. You're talking about the doorknob, right?
Huh? The doorknob? What doorknob?
The doorknob for my bathroom. It was completely broken. See how the top part was unscrewed? And the doorknob's about ready to fall off?
Oh yeah, true. But what does it mean?
In trying to bypass the lock, they ended up nearly removing the entire doorknob. This is another most bewildering act for the room's owner. It proves Makoto is beyond suspicion.
So what? You're saying he wouldn't break the door in his own room? But if the only choice you have is to break it, you break it. There's nothing bewildering about it.
Yeah, that's why you broke it.
You still don't see? Okay, then. Let's take another look at how the incident unfolded. Hopefully that will help you understand.
And now we have to learn a bit more about the non-stop debates. Number of weak spots will go up. No matter how many weak spots, there's essentially only one. Okay. Well, luckily it repeats, so I can do it once over. I'll do it once over, and then we'll shoot a bullet on the second run. Oh, bathroom door frames are bullet.
The incident took place in Makoto's room. Sayaka was first attacked in the main room. She then fled into the bathroom.
Then the killer ran after her. And they got into the bathroom.
At that point, the killer had to try and bust down the door. Because Sayaka had locked it.
And finally, the culprit had Sayaka cornered.
But to finish the job, they stabbed her with the kitchen knife.
It was you, wasn't it, Makoto? Admit it! We already know the answer.
Alright.
The incident took place in Makoto's Sayaka. The first attack, she then fled into the bathroom.
Then the killer ran after, and they got into the bathroom. At that point, the killer had...
Because Sayaka had locked it.
No, it's wrong.
Now let's do it.
The reason my bathroom didn't open wasn't because it was locked. After all, the girls' rooms are the only ones with locking bathrooms, right?
Oh, crap. Almost dropped a thingy.
Yes, now that you mention it, that is true.
Then why didn't your bathroom door open?
Because it was stuck.
Huh? What are you talking about?
Oh, you look a little nervous.
My bathroom door doesn't fit in the frame quite right. Monokuma over there can testify to that.
Yep, true as true can be.
Ta-da!
But you know, you're supposed to be the ultimate lucky student, right? But to have such a cruddy door, that's not lucky at all.
So the reason the door didn't open was just because it was stuck. But the killer didn't know that and assumed it was locked. So they tore apart the doorknob to get in.
Okay, but then why would the killer even think the door was locked in the first place? Everyone should have known you can't lock any of the boys' bathrooms.
The killer could easily make that mistake, thanks to one important detail about the scene of the crime.
Oh, I get it.
I got it!
killer must not have realized that it was my room.
What? Are you saying the culprit didn't even know where he was? That's inconceivable.
Yeah. It's pretty inconceivable at first, like, the first idea of it, but it'll make sense in a sec. I'm diverting because I dropped something. Sorry. There we go.
And yet, he's absolutely right.
Yes, I am, because I'm the best.
Well, to be more specific, what the killer didn't know was that Makoto and Sayaka had switched rooms, which is what led to the misunderstanding about the bathroom. If Sayaka had been in her own room, then...
Then there would have been a lock on the door, and they would have had to break through!
So they had no idea how unnecessary their actions were.
Ultimately, we can't know if it came open by force or simply by accident. But the killer must have been considerably confused, with no idea how they actually got the door opened.
Regardless, it was a pointless act. Wasting time trying to break down a door that wasn't locked is...
stupid.
Definitely something I wouldn't do.
Oh, yeah.
Since I would have known exactly why it wasn't opening, right?
That is a definite possibility.
So the killer would have to be someone who didn't know they'd switched rooms?
Then Makoto couldn't have done it.
Okay, then who did do it?
I'm sorry, but I give up! Quit without saving!
But what happens if we can't decide on who we think did it?
Well, why don't we just vote right now? Majority rules!
Majority rules? You really think that's a good idea?
Yeah, our necks are on the line here. Someone seriously needs to do something. For serious.
Does no one have any other thoughts or questions? It does not matter how trivial they may seem.
Oh, as a matter of fact, I do have one question.
Oh, you.
You don't gotta sound so disappointed.
It's fine, it's fine. Just ask your question.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so, well, I was just wondering, how did the culprit get into Makoto's room in the first place?
Yes. How did the killer get inside?
Maybe Sayaka just dropped the key somewhere and the culprit picked it up. That's possible, right?
I don't think so. That seems way too convenient.
Then, maybe someone picked the lock?
Negative! If you remember, Monokuma made it quite clear that the locks are all unpickable.
Fine. How about this? The killer got in the easy way. They could have knocked and said they wanted to talk or something, and Ms. Maizono just let him in.
No, that can't be it either.
Oh-ho! Trying to argue against me? Sounds like someone doesn't know his place.
Are you kidding me?
Hello? Why exactly can't that be it?
Let's see. There's no way Sayaka would let somebody in because of what we told her, right? What is the answer here? I don't know. Hold on. Let me read them. Alright, so why would she not let anyone in? I'm trying to find why. Would switching rooms count as me saying, no, I talked to her and we decided that's not gonna happen? Hopefully that's it.
I got it!
Because Sayaka was already scared.
Thank you.
Remember? That's why she asked me to switch rooms in the first place.
As a player of Phoenix Wright, I get concerned when evidence is similar and that I don't know if that's going to get the exact response. By the way, this is like Phoenix Wright only a little bit better, I think, just because it's all voiced. Kind of like the fast, quick-draw nature of the debates and stuff. I like it. A bit more stylized. Thank you.
knowing what she'd been through, I just can't believe she would have opened the door for anyone.
And getting on the floor, and then she walked the dinosaur before she got stabbed in the stomach.
What if her being scared was a lie?
Fuck!
Huh?
Holy shit! Man, that's brilliant!
Well, what the hell is that supposed to mean? Why would she lie about something like that?
Oh my god, she was lying about it. She switched rooms with him. She switched the plates as well. Learned about how the... Oh god. Oh god.
I know you don't want to consider it, but look at this and tell me. Can you still deny the possibility?
Come see me in my room. Check the nameplates to make sure you don't get the wrong room. Whoo! She went to kill someone. Oh, please don't tell me she just... Oh.
I found a notepad during my search, and I shaded in the top sheet with a pencil. And these are the words that appear.
Oh, man! I've totally seen people do that on detective shows.
She tried to kill Leon.
When you write, it can leave an imprint. Sketch over the next sheet of paper, and you can see the words. When I saw that, I was like, holy crap! I'd better make sure I rip the paper out before I use it from now on.
It's a pretty old-fashioned technique, but even the classics can be surprisingly useful sometimes. Oh, and I should also mention, I found the notepad on the desk in Makoto's room.
Huh?
Which means, only someone who had been in Makoto's room before the incident could have written it.
Then either it was Makoto who lived there, or Sayaka who switched rooms for a single night.
So, Makoto, did you write this?
No.
No, I didn't. But of course you didn't. Because the note also bears a perfectly legible signature. Sayaka's signature.
But why? Why would she write that?
The note was likely her way of getting in touch with a certain someone. She must have slid it under their door to let them know she wanted to meet with them in secret.
If you got an invitation like that from the ultimate pop sensation, what young man could resist?
Of course, I'm only into 2D, so it wouldn't have any effect on me.
But can we be sure anyone even got this note?
To be fair, all of you are 2D when you look at their models in-game.
And honestly, even if they did, I do not think they are at all involved in what happened.
Huh? What makes you say that?
Would you like to hear what I have to say?
No.
Very well then. Pay attention.
Okay. Here goes nothing. Yep, here comes the nameplates.
Sayaka and Makoto switched rooms, correct? But in the note, the place they were asked to come to, it specifically says, my room.
I see. So if someone read that note, then they would have gone to Sayaka's room.
Exactly. The room that Makoto was staying in. So in other words, even if someone did read the note and did what it said, they would not have any connection to what happened.
It certainly would seem that way.
Wanted to make sure there wasn't anything more specific I was supposed to find. So let's fast forward to that statement again.
The room that Makoto...
No, that's wrong!
The nameplates on Mai and Sayaka's rooms got switched.
They got switched?
That's right. The nameplates got switched, just like the rooms themselves. As a result, the nameplate on Sayaka's room actually had Makoto's name.
And Sprite.
And the nameplate on Makoto's room had Sayaka's.
So what you're saying is, the room Sayaka was staying in was actually marked as her room.
Then... if someone did do what the note said, they would end up at Makoto's room where Sayaka was.
Plus, their rooms are right next to each other, so switching the nameplates would be no problem. And the one who switched the names was... Well, of course it wasn't you, right, Makoto?
Right? Okay, then who did it?
Oh, your knee's weak. Mom's spaghetti. Let's see. The only other person who could have switched it would be Sayaka, who invited him and said, make sure to look at the nameplates.
I got it!
Me and Sayaka were the only ones who ever knew about us switching rooms. So the only other person besides me who would even know to switch the nameplates was Sayaka.
You can also infer as much from her note. She specifically tells the reader to check the nameplate. She would only have written that if she knew the nameplates had been switched.
But why would she switch them in the first place?
She wanted someone to come to the room she was in, and also hide the fact that it was Makoto's room.
What?
Inviting someone to your room, but not telling them you'd switched rooms. Why would anyone do that?
To understand that, we first need to understand what happened after she invited the person into the room. That's where the answer lies.
Yo, why is Mondo over there just so angry?
What happened then was probably whoever she invited over came in and attacked her.
We figured it out. We know who did it. Whoever she invited over is the culprit.
But we still don't know who it is, you goddamn idiot.
Sayaka fought with her killer there in the room, yes? Perhaps the answer to our previous question lies in that initial struggle.
Yes, I think you're right.
Then we just have to figure out what happened during the fight, right?
That reminds me. There was a replica sword at the murder scene. Was that perhaps used during the fight?
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah. What's the deal with that sword?
Sayaka suggested I should hold on to it. I thought it might come in handy if I had to defend myself. It seems pretty likely that the killer used it to break Sayaka's right wrist.
How the hell could you possibly know that's what broke her wrist?
When you look at her wrist, which we can scroll down, right here, gold glitters on it.
All you have to do is take a good look at her broken wrist, and it should become pretty clear. Right there where her wrist is all swollen, there's something glittery there. See?
Is that gold?
It sure is. Specifically, the gold coating from the replica sword. You barely have to touch that stuff, and it'll stick right to you. And there's some on her wrist because...
I got it! Because she got hit with the sword! Right there on her wrist!
I like whenever they have to yell, they do that shaky head thing. I've been meaning to mention that.
I see, I see. And so the truth draws ever closer.
Alright, then it's about time to solve this mystery.
There's a bit more to learn. Why not? I'm getting used to it. Multiple truth bullets. Only one bullet can actually refute the proper statement. You'll have to combine the right truth bullet with the right weak spot. This is actually gonna take some. For our purposes this time, the logic difficulty would be set to mean. Okay. I appreciate it.
When the fighting broke out, the culprit grabbed the sword. And that's when the first blow was dealt. The sword-based sneak attack.
And that's what broke Ms. Maizono's wrist.
So she tried to fight back. She grabbed the kitchen knife she had hidden away. But then the culprit took that from her too.
And they killed her with it.
And that's exactly what happened.
Oh god, I don't know.
When the fighting broke out, the culprit grabbed the sword, and that's when the first blow was dealt. The sword-based sneak attack.
And
That's what broke Miss Mizono's wrist.
Alright, let me think here. We have three options. We got kitchen knife set. Replica sword. Replica sword sheath.
And they killed her with it.
No. Sheath was damaged, though. The sheath was damaged, so I'm going to try and use it on one of these options. Because the sheath was damaged.
The culprit grabbed the
sword. That's when the first
sword-based sneak attack.
And that's what broke with my Zono's wrist.
Good pickback. Knife hidden away. Shoulder with it. Okay, so I have two places I can put this.
When the fighting broke out, the culprit...
I'm gonna guess the first one.
Sneak attack.
Is it right? Is it right? Is it right?
Actually, no. I don't think the fight started with the sword.
I'm guessing I'm right.
Why not?
Because the sword sheath had been scratched.
Yes!
See? There's a gash in it. Like someone cut into it with something sharp.
Something sharp? You mean like the kitchen knife? That was the only sharp thing found at the scene.
Stop jumping ahead. Slow down and explain it so I get what the hell's going on.
If the sword was used first, there wouldn't be any explanation for the scratch on the sheath. If you were going to attack with the sword, you'd take it out of the sheath first, right?
That's true. With the sheath on, it'd be heavy and bulky and useless as shit.
Okay, so how did the sheath get damaged?
If they got attacked with the kitchen knife, maybe they grabbed the sword as a defensive impulse. In that situation, there wouldn't be any time to actually unsheath the sword.
So you're saying the sword was initially used to defend against an attack from the knife?
Which means whoever had the kitchen knife was the one who attacked first.
I think I get it. So here's how it all played out. The culprit came in, found the kitchen knife there somewhere. Then they took the knife and attacked Sayaka before she knew what was happening. So she grabbed the sword to defend herself. But then the culprit took that from her too. Then, after they broke her wrist with the sword, they took the knife and finished it.
Sorry, but I don't think Sayaka used the sword to defend herself.
What? How the hell can you not think that?
Because she never held the sword at all. There's a certain part of her body that makes this clear.
Her palms would have had the gold dust on it.
I got it!
You're talking about her palms, right? The palms of her hands were perfectly clean. So I don't think she ever picked up the sword.
How can you know that just by looking at her palms?
Like I said before, the gold coating on that sword comes right off. All you have to do is touch it. In fact, if you look, you'll notice that a lot of the gold has already come off the handle. It's safe to assume that's because whoever used the sword got some of it on their hands. There's really no way she could have picked it up and come away completely clean.
Maybe she washed her hands after she escaped into the bathroom.
I bet Monokuma's having the best fucking time watching this.
Sorry, but I don't think so.
Why do you say that? Is it because you think I'm ugly?
No, what?
That's not it at all.
There's a certain regulation that talks about what happens. She couldn't have done it because the water is off.
I got it!
According to the Monokuma file, Sayaka's time of death was around 1:30 a.m. In other words, at nighttime. And the water in the bathroom shuts off at nighttime, right?
Oh, I didn't know that. Actually, I haven't taken a shower.
It's been... What?! Yeah.
You're no different. You smell like a big, fat, ugly donkey.
He looks like one.
I'm not sure whether to take that as an insult or a compliment.
Oh my god.
An insult, obviously.
So anyway, if Sayaka never touched the sword, then that means the killer is the only one who used the sword. But hold on. If that's right, then the one who damaged the sheath with the kitchen knife was...
A gun! Sayaka? She had the kitchen knife?
But we already said that the attack started with...
The person with the knife attacked first, and the sword was used as an impromptu defense.
Then the one who attacked first was...
Sayaka?
Now do you understand? She wasn't a blameless victim in this.
No, far from it. It's almost as if she'd been planning to commit a murder of her own.
And he's so excited about it.
She took the knife from the kitchen, then invited the culprit to the room she was staying in. And if it's true that she had the kitchen knife and attacked without provocation...
Indeed. These are all the actions of an assailant.
Which brings up another point. Makoto, Sayaka was the one who suggested you two switch rooms, correct? Maybe the reason she wanted to switch rooms was so that she could pin the crime on you. That is a possibility, is it not?
Holy shit! It's all been a clever ruse!
Sayaka wanted to... on me?
Holy shit!
That would also explain why she would switch the nameplates.
It never occurred to me that that was also a thing going on.
She wanted to get whoever she had targeted to come to Makoto's room where she was staying.
We agreed to help her get out of here. Wasn't really going for that. Dude, fucking Leon can't believe it.
And by committing the murder there, instead of her room, that would implicate Makoto. But for that to work, the target had to be lured out while still keeping the room swap a secret. If the target knew she had switched rooms, they would have become suspicious right away.
So all that's why she switched the names?
But doesn't that plan seem a little risky? For one thing, even if her plan worked, Mr. Naegi would just tell everyone they'd switched rooms.
I don't know. I'm not sure our soft-hearted Makoto is capable of that kind of cutthroat behavior. I'm sure Sayaka realized the same thing, which is why, out of all of us, she asked him to switch rooms.
Plus, she was the ultimate pop sensation. A totally forgettable kid, or a national superstar. Who are you more likely to believe?
Wait, then, you're saying she had this all planned out?
Holy shit!
But in the end, her plan backfired. She launched her attack with the knife, then found herself under attack in turn. That must be when her wrist got broken, and she was forced to drop the knife.
The tables were suddenly turned on her, and she died at the hands of the one she'd planned to murder.
Just hold on! That can't be true! Because...
Hey! Hey! You guys have totally derailed the argument! You're being super boring right now. Come on, hurry up and decide who did it. Wouldn't it be awful if I had to punish you all just because you ran out of time?
Oh yeah, we gotta decide who we think did it.
Makoto, right now you just need to concentrate on figuring out the answer to this mystery. If we can't uncover who murdered Sayaka, it's over for all of us.
No, we still have something. Dying message. This is gonna be so easy.
It's easy just to say, hey, decide who did it. But there just aren't any more clues, right?
Very well. Then let's review all the clues we've found up to this point one more time.
Do we really have time for all that?
Die! Die! If we don't do something, we're all gonna die!
Okay.
It's easy just to say, hey, decide
who did it,
but there just aren't any more clues, right?
Very well. Then let's review all the...
Shoot!
Well, I went a little bit too slow on that one. My bad.
It's easy just to say, hey, decide who did it, but there just aren't any more clues, right?
No, it's wrong.
Now we got it. I was just too late on the button. Now
there
let's do it.
There still might be one clue left. Sayaka's dying message.
Dining? Wait, what did you say?
The dying message. She wrote something on the wall behind her, remember? 11037. Written in her own blood.
You mean Leon upside down, right?
The killer hidden in there.
Well, before we get too far into that, I need to ask, can we really be sure that Sayaka is the one who wrote it?
I got it!
Her left index finger had blood on it. That could only be because she used that finger to write the message.
I see. She broke her right wrist during the fight, so she'd have to use her left hand to write.
Sure. I think we can all agree Sayaka wrote it. But still, what the heck do those numbers mean?
Hey, Chihiro. You're a computer nerd or whatever, right? You should know all about numbers and shit.
No, that's not... Yes, I'm a programmer, but I don't see any kind of meaning in these numbers.
Of course. It's because they're not numbers.
Yeah, of course not.
Oh, yeah, it looks like...
Huh? What? What?
No, it's just... A look at the numbers, assuming they're not numbers. Don't these first two, 1-1, look less like two numbers and more like one letter?
Ah, you're right. The connecting line is barely there, so I assumed it was 1-1, but looking at it now, you could also read it as an N.
Whoa, you might have finally just said something worth a shit.
Our little gray cells are really getting excited now.
But even if that really is an N037, doesn't make any more sense than before.
What?!
Rotate the image 180 degrees.
Someone had to fucking say it.
Oh my god. Now I see. She wrote down the killer's name.
Oh, this is gonna be bad.
Huh? You just shot past the clue part and right onto who did it. So, whose name did she write?
Select someone. Just pick them.
Here's my answer. The key to solving this mystery was simply to rotate the writing 180 degrees. If you turn the message around, it becomes the letters L-E-O-N. L-E-O-N. Or more accurately, Leon.
Oh, God.
What the hell are you talking about? It's just a coincidence. It's just a bunch of random squiggles that happen to look like my name.
No, it's not random at all. She wrote that message on the wall behind her as she was leaning up against it. In that position, she couldn't move to write normally and had to write upside down, as it were. And as a result, when you look at it standing in front of her, it ends up getting flipped. Try it for yourself if you want. Write something sitting like her, and the letters will be inverted.
That sounds like one hell of a stretch to me. I'm the killer? You can't just go and say shit like that.
If you're not the killer, then why did you try to destroy the evidence?
Huh?
You know what I'm talking about, right, Makoto? The evidence Leon tried to get rid of?
Oh, yeah.
I got it! You mean the burnt shirt piece I found laying on the ground by the incinerator, right?
Yep.
The killer stabbed Sayaka. They must have gotten some of her blood on them. And to dispose of the shirt covered in the victim's blood, they threw it into the incinerator.
But one piece burned off and got left behind.
And the killer didn't notice. If they had, they most certainly would have panicked. Isn't that right, Leon?
What?
But is one scrap of fabric enough to conclude that Leon is guilty?
Yeah, I mean, Leon's not the only one wearing a white button-up.
That's right. There are plenty of other people here with shirts like mine. It's just that one little charred piece. There's no way you can say for sure who it belongs to.
You're right. That alone isn't enough. But there are some other points that may reveal the truth.
Are you finally starting to understand? The answers to all the riddles are right here.
Yeah, I think so.
Huh. There's something about we need to pay attention to in order to find out who's responsible. When it was disposed of, no. How or where? Where? Oh, it's not that. Whatever, basically the same answer. How it was. It was disposed by being burned in the incinerator.
Look closely at how the shirt was disposed of. Oh yeah, that's a good point. I think I know what you're gonna say. You can't reach the incinerator without opening the gate in front of the trash room, right? And obviously, you wouldn't be able to hit the switch to turn it on, either.
But how the fucking is that Dragon Ball gonna come into use here?
You'd need the key to get in, and the one with the key was the person on cleaning duty. So the killer had to be whoever was in charge of taking care of the trash, right?
Interesting.
Oh god, he just realized. That's wrong. There's another way to use the incinerator without being the one on cleaning duty. How? You can't fuck. Oh god. Oh, it's flooding. Did he throw the ball? But how can he throw it in. Oh god, he's a baseball player.
The key to the trash room. Whoever was on cleaning duty must have had it, right?
So the only one who could get to the incinerator was the person in charge of the trash?
And you'd have to get close to the incinerator in order to destroy the evidence. Which means the only possible suspect is whoever had the trash room key.
Okay, so the person who would have had the trash room key was... Huh? Me?
Okay, let's fast forward this. And it's right.
Hold on. I think I know how someone could dispose of the evidence without using the trash room key.
But if you can't get past the gate, you couldn't possibly turn on the incinerator, could you?
Yes, you could. If you used this.
What is it? Some kind of glass ball? It's busted to hell.
Actually, it was supposed to be a crystal ball, but...
But how would you use it?
Throw it.
I got it!
The killer simply took aim at the incinerator switch and threw the ball through a gap in the gate. All they had to do was hit that switch, and the incinerator would come to life.
Someone threw that through a gap in the gate?
Remember what you said before, Hifumi? Hifumi had the key. So the only way the incinerator could have been turned on without his knowledge was because the killer was able to hit the switch without opening the gate. Once they'd gotten the incinerator going, all they had to do was ball up the shirt and toss it in.
Hey, come on! What the hell is this?
All you have to do is look at the scene to know that the killer never actually went inside the trash room. The shards of broken glass, the incinerator left running, the piece of shirt that escaped the fire? If the killer had been on cleaning duty, the evidence would have been taken care of much more thoroughly.
Wait, no, just hold on.
But the distance from the gate to the incinerator has to be at least
30 feet. The pinpoint accuracy you'd need to throw a glass ball that far and hit something that small.
Man, you must be really good at fucking baseball to do that.
That's right. There's no way. It'd be impossible.
Difficult, absolutely. Impossible? I don't think so. Because the killer is...
his ultimate baseball star.
I got it! Because the killer is the ultimate baseball star. Isn't that right, Leon? Do you have any idea how stupid you sound right now?
A target 30 feet away would surely be little challenge for the ultimate baseball star.
You can't be serious. I'm not the killer. These goddamn shipper brains have got it all wrong, I'm telling you.
You still won't admit it? Okay, then. Makoto, go ahead and review the incident one more time to make his crime perfectly clear. And with that, we can end this.
Listen to me! What the hell do you mean, end this?
Say what you want, Leon. But all the questions have been answered. And the truth has been revealed. Now here's what happened.
Closing argument. Every case has one last element to bring the class trial to an end. This is a closing argument. Complete the summary. You'll have to reproduce flow of the events for the case in the form of a comic book. Okay. Holy cow! You'll get a hint that may lead to a breakthrough.
I think I'd better take one more look back at the case from the beginning. Last night, the killer went to the room Sayaka was in. In other words, my room. From what we can tell, Sayaka invited that person there intending to kill them. She attacked them with the knife she'd taken from the kitchen earlier. But then something happened that she wasn't prepared for. They grabbed the fake sword I put in my room and fought back. During the struggle, a strike from the sword broke Sayaka's right wrist. And that's when she lost her grip on the kitchen knife. Finding herself cornered, Sayaka panicked and ran into the bathroom. The killer went after her, but couldn't get the bathroom door open. What they didn't know was that my bathroom door got stuck easily, and there was a trick to opening it. Sayaka knew about that because I told her, but of course the killer had no way of knowing. So instead, the killer forced the door open, took the kitchen knife, and stabbed Sayaka. But with what strength she had remaining, Sayaka left a dying message. To keep the killer from noticing, she wrote it on the wall behind her. And with that, all her strength was gone. With Sayaka dead, the killer quickly began destroying the evidence. First, they took off their shirt, which was covered in their victim's blood. Then they took the lint roller in my room and cleaned up the entire area. They wanted to make sure they got rid of any trace they'd ever been there. Afterwards, the killer headed to the trash room to destroy their bloody shirt. They tried to burn the shirt using the incinerator there, but the trash room was blocked off by an especially sturdy gate, preventing access to the incinerator. So they came up with a plan to use Hiro's crystal ball, which he'd left in the laundry room. The killer managed to throw the ball through the gap in the gate and hit the incinerator switch. For any normal person, that'd be an impossible throw. But the killer had the confidence to take a shot. And that's because the killer was the ultimate baseball star. The crystal ball, thrown with absolute precision, hit the switch on the incinerator, which then quickly roared to life. Having destroyed the final piece of evidence, they left the area with, I imagine, a sigh of relief. But there was one thing they missed. Part of the shirt they'd thrown into the fire burnt away and fell out of the incinerator. The killer didn't notice this, and so left behind a piece of indisputable evidence. Isn't that right, Leon? It would appear that Hiro simply forgot his crystal ball in the laundry room.
Also, in case you're wondering, because the music kind of has a hard cut during that comic, I fucked up. One of the panels was a screwdriver, which was never used, but they wanted you to use that as an example of how the knife was supposed to be used. Fucking goddamn it.
You went there to try and wash the blood out of your shirt, and that's where you saw it, right? Seeing the ball, you thought of a way to take care of everything.
So, Leon, do you object to anything that's been said?
Do I object? Hell yes, I object! Of course I do! I object, I object, I object! I mean, all of this is just a bunch of stupid theories. You need evidence. Where's the evidence? Without evidence, it's all bullshit. It's bullshit, and I refuse to acknowledge it.
Well then, I guess this is as good a time as any to present the evidence that proves you did it.
Oh?
I believe you're in possession of that evidence.
Once I look at it, I'll know, yes. Bullet time battle. All right. You want to destroy opponent's statements in time with rhythm. Match your button match presses with tempo, blah blah blah. Tap and press the X button to lock on to an opponent's statement. Destroy the statement you've locked on to with the triangle button. Alright. Deal enough damage to the opponent, and their weak spot statement will appear. At this point, press triangle to shoot it down with a truth bullet like any other statement. Alright. How am I supposed to have fun with this?
You removed the screws from the doorknob. They didn't use anything from your room to do it. Instead, they must have used something that belonged to them.
Oh my god, he took his!
I refuse to acknowledge you! You're stupid! Stupid, stupid, stupid!
If we check his toolbox, we'll know.
Stupid, 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 stupid! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! It wasn't me! So
Okay, I think I'm doing it right.
Stop talking. Shut up. Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance.
I'm damaging him.
You lie. Shut up. Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance. It wasn't me. Stupid.
There. Final strike.
Where's your proof?
This should prove it.
Well, we broke it.
The screws on the bathroom doorknob were removed. I wonder what kind of tool the killer used to remove them.
I mean, it had to be a screwdriver, right?
Oh, yeah. I'm pretty sure the tool kits we got each had one inside.
And that must be what he used. There aren't any other tools anywhere.
But the toolkit in my room had clearly never been used.
That's because the culprit didn't know it was your room. They thought they were in Sayaka's room.
Only the boys got toolkits, so the killer naturally assumed there wouldn't be one in there.
Okay.
Then whose toolkit did the killer use?
Stupid, stupid, stupid!
It had to be their very own toolkit.
Stupid, 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 stupid!
Leon, would you mind showing us your toolkit? If I'm right about this, then the screwdriver will show some evidence of being used.
Stupid, stupid, stupid!
Huh? And if you say you used it for something else, you'll have to explain exactly when, where, and why.
And let me say this right now. I lost it isn't an excuse at this point.
Stupid.
So, you have no rebuttal?
Then it would seem we are finished here.
I'll say this much, given this entire case that we have just gotten an A rank on. Now, we found out the killer, but as soon as I realized, oh shit, Sayaka is the one that initiated it, I have immediately not hated Leon for killing her, because really, it was self-defense and the person attacked you. Like, she brought this on herself. It's just unfortunate that he's dead. Like, I have sympathy for him. Some may say, oh, he could have just left. Yeah. I feel sympathy for him. Unfortunately, we have to continue this.
Looks like you've reached your verdict. Then are we ready to cast our votes? You all have a lever in front of you. Use it to make your selection. Oh, just to remind you all, make triple sure you vote for someone. You wouldn't want to be punished for something so minor, right?
Are you kidding? Wow.
Okay, then let's get excited!
Woo!
Who will be chosen as the blackened? Will you make the right choice? Or the dreadfully wrong one? What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be?
That suit's amazing. Ah! Jackpot! Oh, I got it right on the money. I like how as soon as we get out of the trial, they're like, alright, there goes our voice acting budget. Yahoo! Given how much voice is in there, I can now understand why this game's silent a lot. Leon Kawada.
Huh?
Hey, hold on.
You son of a bitch!
What are you talking about? We just got through a part where he was the one who was gonna get murdered.
I didn't have a choice.
Really, so, that's how this went. Like, he may have beaten her physically and she hid in a bathroom. It's like, why go after her? She fucking attempted this once. She'll attempt it again. And I'm pretty sure there's no rule that would have, like, yeah.
None of you are any different. I was just unlucky. That's all.
Not like me.
Hey, come on!
The truth is, the Sayaka was trying to frame Naegi. And the person that we're about to judge isn't the piece of shit I thought he was in the beginning. And it's also not necessarily your fault. It's Monokuma's because of the video. So really, it's the bear asshole. Yep, all from the beginning. What a ruse. Oh, man. Calm down.
Phew.
Yeah. Well, really, we would have just been trapped here forever, and it would have taken a lot longer for a murder to happen. And he can't have that. This bear can't deal with that.
That's enough.
Yeah. Go ahead and not make sure we die.
Calm down.
Because if you hit him, another one will come out, and you'll just get killed in some hilarious way.
Yes, indeed.
The Black and Leon Kawada will receive his punishment.
Punishment?
What, do you think this wasn't coming, bro? I feel bad for you, but man, it's coming.
I mean, execution?
Oh, God.
Wait a second.
He really didn't, but this place isn't exactly fair.
Yeah, that's it.
Is that okay? Hmm.
Doesn't matter if he took the time to find a good way to kill her.
So that's why.
Oh.
The one to blame is him, but if we have to blame someone, might as well go with the facts.
Unbelievable. Hey,
Thrills, chills, kills!
Okay, no one was waiting for this.
I'm begging you! Please, don't do this!
Hey, come on now!
Stop, please!
Now then, I've prepared a very special punishment!
Oh.
No, 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 no!
Let's give it everything we've got! It's punishment time!
No!
Oh no! Oh yeah, he's a bear.
Well... Hey,
Shit.
Son of a bitch! Oh god, is this being broadcasted? Even after he was gone, we stood there forever unable to move. Actually, it wasn't that long. Everyone just lost their sense of time because a man was killed by baseballs.
Just a second. Makoto. Listen. It's true.
Yeah, we know that that was gonna happen. You know, she's right. Why else would she have written the name?
However, so
that does make sense. Her whole plan was to manipulate it, and true, it would have gotten us killed. But if she wasn't even going to be able to leave, it's like, hey, why screw him over? She's the assistant. It's still fucked up! But like, it's still stupid, but
certainly.
What it really means is that both those motherfuckers are guilty in some way. Leon, a bit. Her, a bit. But there are good sides to it.
Anyway,
there's some gray in there. The point is, fuck the bear. How about that?
Right. Correct.
True. Two people I was doing, spending time with are dead.
What?